Nvidia recently announced that they will be supporting adaptive sync on FreeSync monitors, which was only possible with AMD cards earlier. So this is great news because G Sync is a proprietary standard and Nvidia has their own scalar chips in G Sync monitors, which increases their price. And considering that both FreeSync and G Sync had mostly similar results, paying extra for adaptive sync sucked, especially when most people use Nvidia cards for gaming. And FreeSync is something that most of the newer gaming monitors are supporting. But now, things have changed, and the update for Nvidia's 10 and 20 series cards that allows G-Sync compatibility on FreeSync monitors went live a few hours ago. And the great thing is that in addition to officially certifying G-Sync compatibility with some monitors that they have tested, they are also letting anyone with a FreeSync monitor enable G-Sync and test if it works for them. So we are going to test how well G-Sync works with my 2-year-old monitors. These are LG's 27UD68P 4K IPS monitors which support FreeSync from 40 to 60 Hz. And you obviously won't be able to use G-Sync in a range that your monitor doesn't support. Hey guys, I am Siddharth and let's test G-Sync on a FreeSync monitor. So we will test this with my RTX 2080 Ti, which is a 20 series card, but this will also work with a 10 series Pascal card. So all you need for enabling G-Sync is a FreeSync monitor, a 10 or 20 series card, and Nvidia's latest driver for the GPU. Then you need to make sure that you have enabled FreeSync on your monitor, otherwise it won't show up in Nvidia control panel. Then you need to go to Nvidia control panel and make sure that G-Sync is enabled, and that's it. So there are demos that let you test adaptive sync, but we will test this with Assassin's Creed Odyssey as that is a more real life example. We will increase the resolution scaling of this game to 140% because the 2080 Ti can mostly handle it at 60 frames per second maxed out at 4K, so we won't see enough of a drop in FPS. So now as you can see that we are at 50 to 60 FPS and when I look around you can see that we are getting really terrible tearing at 4K. So if your card can't deliver a constant 60 FPS, you will get a lot of this terrible tearing. And even above 60 FPS, enabling VSync also adds input lag, though you can use FastSync, which we are not going to discuss in this video. So now, let's enable G-Sync and see if this monitor can handle it. And as you can see, it can handle it without any issues. And now we don't have any tearing issues that we experienced earlier. And just look at the difference it made. This is a much better experience if you don't want VSync or can't match your FPS to your monitor's refresh rate. So that was really great. I think that we can say that it just works. You had to pay a hefty premium to get G-Sync, especially at 4K. So it's really great to see that many people like me are just going to get it for free. Now, G-Sync will not work on every FreeSync monitor and you might get issues like flickering, strobing or just a blank display. And you will just have to test whether it works on your monitor. So don't expect to get guaranteed results, but I will also link to a Google sheet in the video description in which there's a list of monitors that people have tested with G-Sync. So you can check that out and see whether it will work for you or not. Though, none of this is guaranteed to work as the results might even vary from panel to panel. If you look at 4K 144Hz monitors like Acer XV273K and XB273K, you will find that the only difference is lack of G-Sync on XV273K. And you will have to pay an extra 30,000 rupees or around $400 to get this feature. But now, with this update, the XV273K is certified to support G-Sync. So anyone planning to purchase the XB273K can just get the XV273K and save a lot of money. And no card will be able to deliver constant 144 FPS at 4K anytime soon. So I think in that case, G-Sync could prove to be a really great feature to have. So that was it for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed watching it. It's really great to see Nvidia doing something that actually makes things cheaper for the consumers, and the G-Sync support being so expensive is just something that I really hated. So I'm very happy with this announcement for everyone. So give this video a thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe to channel with bell icon for more videos like this, and I will see you in the next one.